regreso aquí en Auto 060 y ahora vamos a pasar a una entrevista muy interesante que vamos a hacer en inglés. Así que now we're switching back to English because we have a very interesting interview about wireless charges for the cars, this new technology which is being developed here in the United States. And we're talking to, we're going to now talk to Leroy Johnson of co-chair of the Automotive Application Group, or WPC. How are you, Leroy?
I'm fine.
Thank you very much. So, as I was explaining, this is a brand new technology, or maybe not that brand new. I mean, it's brand new for cars, but it's wireless charging stations for cell phones in the car, and some of them are already being installed from the factory, right?
That's correct.
So can you tell a little bit how does this technology works? I mean, it's pretty cool that you can just put your phone somewhere and it's been charged.
Yes, let me explain it simply a little bit. It works off magnetic induction, and it's sort of similar to radio waves. But if you set your cell phone down on a surface that has a transmitter in it, like a center console or cup holder of a car, you could charge your cell phone without plugging it in. And this would work for tablets and other electronic devices too. But in theory, it eliminates the cord that you plug in now in the car. But then the same cell phone, when you walk into your office, you can just set it on a charging spot on your desk or on your nightstand at home or at a hotel, and you won't have to bring your charger everywhere. But it's certainly going to be nice to have it in your car.
Yeah, and this technology, there's already applications, that there's already products out there in the market to just people can buy, right? And as you said, put in your office, in your house, or whatever.
Yes, obviously it's been available for residential and office applications, but now it's, and it takes a little longer to get them into the OEM cars, but they're now out there. There's four cars on the market that I'm aware of already that have them in the car. And there's more that are more model years and more models that are being soon to be released. The four that I'm aware of that are on the market is there's two Toyota versions, the Avalon, which is a 2013 Avalon, which is already out, and actually since March, the Toyota Avalons have an option for this wireless charging. Then the Prius is going to be coming out too. It's actually already available in Japan in the Prius, but it's not available yet in the U.S.
Yeah, they always got things first, right?
And then the Jeep Cherokee, that's available. Actually, it's available next month in August. That's going to be installed in the factories. So wireless charging will be in the Jeep Cherokee 2014 models. And then it's already available in Korea for the SsangYong car, and its model is the Chairman, and that's been out since May. So there's four cars internationally I'm aware of, and now there's there's probably about 40 cell phones that are already on the market internationally that have a receiver built into them. So you don't,
okay,
the new phones you have may already have it in it, and they're the big phones. They're the Samsungs, the Galaxy S3 and S4, they're the Google Nexus 4, Nokia Lumina models, LG phones, Motorola phones, you know, all the big phone companies are coming out with it built into their phone.
Did I miss a hearing Apple there? I mean, is the iPhone compatible for this system too?
You have good ears. Apple does what Apple wants to do.
I know. We heard that a lot.
At this point, I don't know what they're doing. But I do know that there's several adaptive solutions so that if you already have an Apple 3, 4, or 5, you can just slide a sleeve over it or plug in a little adapter into the charging port, and it'll make the Apple phone work wirelessly, too.
Oh, okay. That's great. And when we're talking about this technology, what's the price, more or less, for this option? As you mentioned, some of them are being factory installed, and some of them are they like aftermarket accessories, and what are the prices
for
those?
Besides the ones I mentioned that are OEM, there are some aftermarket products on the market too. Let's see, I'm trying to think. I only know of two of them off the top of my head here. AudioVox has one, and then Nokia has a car charger too, and those are both wireless. I can't tell you the prices. I honestly don't know what the individual companies are putting on those prices for on the features. But if you're thinking about comparing it to an office or home,
yeah,
the actual chargers Which my company makes, Leggett and Platt makes the chargers for not only automotive applications, but for the office and residential. And they cost in the same range as what a traditional wall wart charger for your phone would cost.
Yeah. This wireless power consumption is, it's an American company, right? I mean, this is developed here in the States, or?
It's international. Okay. There's over 140 members, and they're the major company, major electronic companies of the world. The Philips, Samsung's, Panasonic, Toshiba's, Sony's, and all the phone companies, obviously, like Nokia, LG. These companies are involved, as well as the providers like Verizon. So it's international, and this consortium of companies meets about every other month, and they often meet in the U.S., but they also meet internationally, different locations. The next meeting happens to be in China. The last one was in Finland. But when we get together with all these companies, we bring our products, and we make sure they're interoperable so that the cell phone that's made in Japan is going to work with the car that's made in the United States.
Yeah, I think the car manufacturers are already getting together in that kind of a way too. For example, for the plug-in cars, they have, like, for example, the same connector to the car, which is universal. So this is more or less the same concept. That a lot of companies work together to make a product that be available for many different cars and cell phones at the same time.
You're right. In fact, what's easy for the consumer is all they got to remember is Qi. It's a capital Q-I. It's pronounced Qi, C-H-E-E. But Qi is the international standard for wireless power, just like Bluetooth is for transferring data. So when you see a little Qi symbol in your cup holder or your car, you'll know you can put your cell phone right there. Okay. If you see that on your table at a McDonald's restaurant, you'll know you can put your cell phone on that Qi symbol and it'll charge. So it's just sort of like the Bluetooth symbol. You come to know it and expect it in different places.
Yeah. And this is an application that can actually work in at a larger level. I understand that there are some manufacturers that are already experimenting with charging stations for electric cars in this same way. I mean, with no wires or anything. You just like put your car over a platform in your garage or something like that, and then it will charge. Is that correct?
Yes, and it's very much like you described. But to describe a platform, it's almost like a manhole cover. It's usually a circular disc that sits. It can even be embedded into the asphalt at a parking lot.
Okay.
So if you pulled into a public parking spot, you could just drive over this charging area with your car. Or at home, it could be a pad that you drive over. And then there's a receiver coil on the bottom of your car that picks up the signal and transfers it to your battery.
Yeah. And so this technology is going to probably what is going to solve all the infrastructure or a lack of charging stations around the country and the world, right? I mean, and that's one of the concerns of people who are thinking of buying electric or plug-in cars have, because they can drive for a little bit, but then they want to charge the car. So this technology, having the charging station on the ground in parking slots, that's probably going to solve the problem?
Yes, and there is a trend towards that. Now, that's pretty slow because you can imagine what it is to rip up roadways and put these in our parking lot. But it is coming, and there are already inductive power systems for electric vehicles. But I think where the consumer is going to first notice it is in the electronic devices, when they can charge that cell phone or that tablet in their car. And you know, internationally, everybody's got a cell phone with them at all times now.
Yeah.
And that's an exaggeration, but it's getting close. But people stay connected, and that's where they're going to first really appreciate wireless charging and the Qi standard, is when it's that consumer electronic device.
Yeah, that's really, really interesting. It's pretty amazing how fast things have changed in the auto, I mean, in every industry. I mean, with technology, I mean, the iPhone came out about 6 years ago, and now we're like talking about this technology. Can you envision what are we going to see in the next 5 or 6 years with all these technologies?
Well, the company I work for is Leggett & Platt, and my title is Senior Director of Emerging Technologies. You'd think
I'm talking to the right person then.
you'd think I'd be able to answer that question.
Yeah.
But technology emerges so quickly, changes so rapidly. 5 to 6 years is a lifetime in electronic devices. I can imagine that the world will be less and less physically connected to cords in the next 5 or 6 years, but more and more constantly connected to each other. So, the internet has helped us do that, but to be connected to the internet, we need some type of device. And it's beginning to be the smartphone, and it's also beginning to be tablets. So as those smaller devices are the tools we use to do social activities, but also to do our business activities, we're going to want to charge snack everywhere.
Exactly.
So when we go to a public space, if it's a waiting room at an airport or a doctor's office, if it's a public space like even schools, kids will have ways to charge snack their devices everywhere they are. I've worked recently with some school systems that have put wireless charging in the schools for the students because they now totally understand and expect students to bring their phones with them to school.
Yes, it's a learning tool nowadays. So Leroy Johnson from the Wireless Consumption, we're going to post all the information on our Facebook page. Thank you very much for your time. Unfortunately, we're running out of minutes here.
Okay.
We can be talking for a long time. Thank you very much for all the information and
of this
great technology.
Okay.
Thank you. Esto es Auto 060. Yo soy Javier Mota. Ya regresamos con el fin de este show. Thank you.